Hello, Windows Universe. Michael with the Windows Universe. In this video, we will look at how to run the Windows Troubleshooter in Windows 10 to resolve problems. As always, we will link an article in the description below that will go further into depth. As a caveat, this video is based off the Windows 2004 update, so some of the tips and screens may look different from those with earlier builds. In the search bar on the task menu, type in Troubleshoot and open Troubleshoot Settings. As you see, there are three recommended troubleshooting options. Run the troubleshooting automatically and don't notify you. Run troubleshooters automatically, then notify you. And the third one, ask before running troubleshooters. You can then see that there are any troubleshooters that Windows recommends that you run right now. You can click to view the troubleshooting history. And then there's the button, additional troubleshooters. Bluetooth finds and fixes any problems with Bluetooth devices. With incoming connections troubleshooter, you can find and fix problems with incoming computer connections and your firewall. If your keyboard is giving you trouble, then run the keyboard troubleshooter. Should you be facing problems with your wireless and other network connections, then your network adapter troubleshooter is your go-to. If you're having power problems, the power troubleshooter is your go-to. This one is especially good for laptops that are experiencing short battery life. If you're having issues running older programs on your Windows 10 platform, the Program Compatibility Troubleshooter is an excellent resource. Recording Audio Troubleshooter will help you with any microphone or sound control issues. If you're having problems finding things on Windows Search, then the Search and Indexing Troubleshooter is your go-to. The Shared Folders Troubleshooter is something to use if you're having issues with accessing files and folders on other computers. If you're using Cortana or other speech recognition programs, then start with running the speech translator. Problems with playing movies, TV shows, or videos? Well, then you can find and fix problems in the video playback. If you're having trouble with Windows Store apps, then run the Windows Store apps troubleshooter. If you need help in finding and fixing problems with connecting to the internet or to websites, run the internet connections troubleshooter. You can find and fix problems with the playing audio troubleshooter. Here's one that a lot of people will probably end up needing. Finding and fixing problems with printing can be solved with your printing troubleshooter. And if you've just downloaded a Windows update and you're not able to run it, or you're just having trouble with Windows updates, run the Windows Update Troubleshooter. There is a way to view more troubleshooters. Go to the Control Panel. Go to All Control Panel Items. Go to Troubleshooting, click on View All, and as you can see, a few other troubleshooters show up, such as System Maintenance, Internet Explorer Safety, Internet Explorer Performance. Now, there is one other important troubleshooter, but it's not listed in either location, the Hardware and Devices Troubleshooter. It still exists, but to use it, you need to take a few extra steps. Open the command prompt. I like to use the administrator one. And type in msdt.exe space hyphen id device diagnostic and hit enter. You'll see a dialog pop up, and this will allow you to run the Hardware and Devices Troubleshooter. Did this video help you? Are there troubleshooting devices that are no longer listed that you know shortcuts to get to? Let us know about that in the comments down below. And for more helpful hacks in the world of Windows 10, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. And hey, if this video helped you, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content to make your digital universe just so much better.